Good morning.
Good morning.
Let's try that one more time. We're not going to be as loud today in general because we're having a Taizé style worship service, but we could be a little rowdy this morning, so let's just try it one more time. Good morning.
Good morning.
Welcome to First Church. It's really good to see you guys this holiday weekend. We know that a lot of our loved ones are traveling this weekend. A ton of our young adults are down in North Carolina at National Young Adult Conference, including Pastor Lexi, who's one of the keynote speakers down there. We want to make sure that you're aware, right after service today, we're planning to eat upstairs, so we hope that you guys will hang out. We're going to have kind of a cookout theme meal together, and so we'd love for you to hang. We will have some vegetarian options as well for those who are on plant-based diets. If this is your first time in the space for a while, I just want you to know we do have exits in the back on both sides. If there's any reason we would have to leave quickly, you can use either exit. We also have an accessible bathroom here on the side, as well as bathrooms back the hallway. If you would need anything, just sort of raise your hand and one of our deacons or ushers will try to attend to whatever your needs might be. We do ask that at some point while you're here, if you would check in at the welcome table. We are continuing to keep track of who's here and who's not, just in the event that we have to contact people about the spread of the virus and things of that nature. Thank God we have not had any much issue with that as a faith community. But I do want to encourage you to continue to be vigilant. You might have noticed that numbers are rising in our area. It's not a time to just do whatever, okay? So let's continue to be vigilant about taking care of each other and taking care of our own health as well.
There are masks back there.
If anybody wants one, we have them. There's no pressure to wear them at all, but they are there. Let's see. I think those are the kind of nuts and bolts things we wanted to talk about. If you're able, we want to invite you to please stand. We're going to sing our opening hymn, which is Be Thou My Vision. And this whole service, we're really just inviting the Spirit of God to guide us, to guide our hearts, to guide our minds. And I thought this was a fitting hymn to begin our time together. So if you would, please stand and sing with us.
Hallelujah.
May we see it. announcements this morning. We are entering a season where your pastors are going to be here and there and everywhere. We're praising God for the opportunity to do a lot of different things and to be able to say yes. We do want you to know that as we say yes to things, we're making sure that one or the other of us is around. So like I said, this weekend, Pastor Lexi is down in North Carolina. I'm leaving a work camp back in Rwanda this coming week. I leave on Thursday, and I'll be gone for a couple weeks, and then we're both at annual conference in July. There's some other things in there. So we just want you guys to be aware, and we will be putting the times that we'll be away in the bulletin so that everybody is aware of what's going on. Vacation Bible School is coming up next month. We do have registration for that at the welcome table. And so I see some kids in the house today. Please talk to your parents about coming and being a part of Vacation Bible School. This will be in collaboration with the junior high work camp from the denomination that comes. And it will begin on June 19th and go through June 23rd. That last day, the 23rd, is kind of like a family fun day. So parents, we want you to make sure that you come and hang out on Thursday with us of the VBS week. There's a lot of other things here in the bulletin, so just make sure that you take note of them. In 2 weeks from today, we'll be having our church council meeting right after church, and that is for everybody, basically, anybody who's a regular attendee, or if you just want to like know what's going on in the life of the church, feel free to come and hang out with us. Generally, we just pack our own lunches and have the meeting right after service. As far as voting on different business items, which I don't think there are any this time, that is limited to members. Yes?
There's two items.
Okay, there's two items of business, and members will be the ones that can vote on those business items. But you can share your opinion, whether or not you know, you're a member or not. So we would love for as many of you to plan to stay after service to be a part of our council meeting, and that'll be on June 12th. I sent around the council packet. There's a bunch of errors in it, apparently, so apologize for that. We'll send around an edited version, and the revised version will also be on the table next week, so you'll have plenty of time to check that out as well.
Training for Bible school next Sunday. Any of the folks that are leading teens, etc., in Bible school, that takes place next Sunday right after church, June 5th.
So if you've said yes when Alyssa or Sam or Pastor Lexi has asked you to be a part of Vacation Bible School, please plan to stay after service next Sunday for that teacher training time. We also, you might have noticed in your bulletin, we're going to be having a special offering in a couple weeks as well, and this will be an insert the next couple weeks, and then we'll have a verbal announcement from the pulpit in 2 weeks, I believe, as well. As you can see, our order of service is a little different than a typical week, so as you look this over, I don't know how many of you have been involved in a Taizé-style worship before. This is going to be a service once we're done with our offering and we enter into the Taizé time. This will be a time of worship that is centered around reflection, centered around short choruses, scripture reading, and silent prayer. And I just wanted to kind of make sure that you're aware that that's where we're headed this morning, so that we can prepare our hearts and prepare our minds for that time. The times of silence, for some of you, might feel like a very long period of silence. It's not going to be like, 10 seconds, because we really want to dwell with each other and dwell in the Spirit of God and see what God reveals to us this morning. Okay, with all of that being said, we want to invite you to come from where you're seated and to greet each other in the name of the Lord. Welcome each other into this space. If you've not been here before, our greeting time is not a time to shake hands with whoever's next to you. It's a time to really come out from where you're seated and greet each other. We'll be singing two choruses, Guide My Feet, a cappella, and we'll be singing I Shall Not Be Moved. So as we sing together, as we welcome the Lord's presence in this place, let's also welcome one another to this space to worship the Lord in spirit and in truth.
To run this race in vain.
Lord. And you can be seated. We're going to invite our ushers forward. And I know the offering doesn't normally come this early in service, but we are, again, trying not to break up our reflection time, the time of Taizé that'll come. And so the ushers would move the table over. Let's play a breath. Pray a blessing. Instead of play a blessing. Let's pray a blessing upon what we'll bring to the Lord, recognizing that it's more than just our finances we offer the Lord today. We offer God our time, the things we're good at, our talent, and all that we are. So let's pray. Father God, we thank you for this opportunity to just give a portion of all you blessed us with. God, we pray that you use these gifts to further your kingdom right here and right now, right here in South Allison Hill and throughout our community. God, we know that all that we have, it comes from you. And we just thank you for your blessings. We thank you, Lord, that we can praise you in this way. Help us to not hold anything back today. Help us to surrender all of who we are so that you can use us exactly the way you want to use us, Father. Right now, Lord, prepare our hearts, prepare our minds for our time of reflection, Lord. We just thank you for how good you are. We thank you for how faithful you are. That your love is bestowed upon us, even though we don't deserve it, Father. God, we just pray that we'll give cheerfully today with joy, with celebration, as we praise you with our giving. We love you. We thank you. It's in Jesus' name we pray. Amen. Amen. As you feel led, feel free to come. If you're not able to come forward, that's okay. Just raise your hand and put the gift. Just raise your hand and the ushers will bring the basket to you if you prefer.
You
gather today and sing the song that says, all the things that I've been through, all the things we've been through, use it for your glory. Just strikes me today how much we as a faith community have been through, how much we as the city of Harrisburg have been through, we as each individual household have been through, we as these United States of America have been through recently. So much to deal with, Lord. We just pray, Lord, that you'll just give us a sense of your unfailing love, your peace that surpasses all of our human understanding. And we can't make sense of all that's happening, all that has happened. And God, we cry out to you today. We pray that your will would be done, that your kingdom would come right here on earth as it is in heaven, Lord, that you would move us and help us to take the responsibility seriously to be a part of your work as your spirit moves among us, that we might be your hands and feet, Jesus, right here and right now, where death-dealing policies, where just hate and fear abound, that we would bring your light, that we would bring life, that we would bring truth, that we would bring peace and hope and love, Lord God. And it's not us that's bringing it, it's you that brings it through us, Lord. Help us never to get that twisted and think that it's us. But also don't let us get it twisted and think that we can just sit there and not be a part, because you're calling us to be a part. Help us to get that balance right today, Lord. God, we offer you all of who we are. We gave you some financial gifts today, but we want to give you all of who we are. That a real change in this world might happen. Change hearts, change minds today, Lord God. We want to sacrifice it all today that you might use us the way you want to. We love you, Lord, and we thank you. In Jesus' name we pray and believe. Amen. Amen. This time we want to invite the children to come forward. Jesus loves me, this I know. She has to go and
parents and she are living in a shelter, and she has to figure out what to do next. Where should she live? The Red Cross is helping them. Have you ever heard of the Red Cross? Yes, the Red Cross. So Maria's having a lot of emotions, and but she gets to go and play with all these things in this kit of comfort. Okay, look, you see? There's toys in there. She's going to play with that because there are people like me and other people of the Church of the Brethren that go to help the Red Cross, and we work with this thing called Children's Disaster Services. Okay? Children's Disaster Services, and they have a program to play with kids and help them deal with these things. And you know what? Right now they are in a place in Texas helping the children deal with things there. So we are, it's a very timely time in this story. All right, are you ready? Maria's Kit of Comfort. Can everybody see? Sorry, friends, you can't all see, but I will read loudly so you can hear. Okay, let's see. What does Maria see in the sky there? What?
Bubbles.
Yes, bubbles! Bubbles! Because Maria's scared. She doesn't know she wants to go play with these people. But look! Oh! The bubbles are coming out of this room! Bubbles, something fun. Let's see. Maria peeks in and sees bubbles in the air. The beautiful bubbles are floating in the air. You think she's going to go in? You think? Well, and what did I tell you this stands for?
Doctor
or the Red Cross. The Red Cross is helping. The Red Cross is helping. She goes in. Oh, what's in there? She feels a bit shy, but then hears someone say, "Oh, welcome, Maria. Please come in and Maria, that she's going to go in and play? Because when something scary happens to you, you may not feel like playing. You can take your time. Take your time. The soft purple dough helps Maria relax. She squeezes it and rolls it and makes it with tracks. Playing with sand and water helps you feel calm. You don't have to make everything. Just play. You ever play with sand? You ever play in a sandbox? Yeah, at the beach, excellent. Yes, the beach has a lot of sand, doesn't it? Yep. And Play-Doh, look, she's making a snake. You ever do that? The pictures she paints shows a world that is sad. It lets her be frightened or worried or mad. See, look, it looks like the clouds are crying, doesn't it? Yep. You can tell your story with words, or you can also tell your story with no words at all. You ever draw a picture? Yep. And it tells you how you're feeling. Look, now what's she playing with?
Puppets.
Yes, puppets. The puppets can talk when Maria's nearby. I lost all my toys, Bunny says. Remember I told her she lost her house? Do you think maybe they're going to give her some toys to play with?
Yeah.
I do. Let a puppet talk for you, especially if your story feels sad or scared. Puppets can talk. Let's see. She picks out some books and sits down on the floor. She reads about problems and feelings in the world. Storybooks help you find words for how you feel deep and inside. Who likes to read here? Or if you don't know how to read, can your mommy or your daddy or grandma read for you? Yeah, that's awesome, right? Oh, here she sees danger. But look, there's help on the way. Emergency vehicles saving the day. Who's coming to help? The fire trucks? Ambulance, medic, that's a good word. Well, she's playing, but she's working it out. They're working it out. She says, ambulances and fire trucks go and sit back up, everybody. And be part of the team that's helping other people. So people, adults, are there to help you when you call. Isn't that important? Let's see. The children toss beanbags up high in the sky. Maria jumps higher for one that flies by. You might feel sad and happy at the same time. Sometimes running around gives you worries or rest. So she's able to play with these other kids. You ever play beanbags? Like, catch. Yep. Maria sees Jackson and shows him a game. Their language is different. Their play is the same. What language do you think Maria might speak? Anyone know? English? She might speak English. What other language? Maybe Spanish. Yep. What about Jackson? What language do you think he might speak? Maybe Japanese. Who knows? But you always have to speak words with someone? No. You can play. sometimes by playing games, you don't need to speak the same language to laugh and be silly. When you guys are playing back there, you're not saying anything, right? You're dancing together. You're making a joyful noise under the board. Oh, the puzzles are scattered. It looks like a mess, but friends work together, and now there's success. All those puzzle pieces might feel like a disaster, but now you know, I can do this. Who likes to do puzzles here? Yeah. I'm not the greatest puzzle person. You like to do them? You dumped out all your puzzles and then had to... Well, that's going to be hard when you have the mixed puzzle. I bet your mom or dad can help you get it back together. It's easy to talk in this comforting space. Maria smiles back at her welcoming face. If you want to talk about what happened, now you feel someone will listen. Maria finds Teddy and snuggles him tight. Don't worry, she smiles as she whispers, good night. You can tell your worries to dolls or stuffed animals. They'll help you feel safe and strong. What else? A giant bear on the things, right? Oh, the bubbles look peaceful while floating away. Maria feels hope for a better day. Look, and there's the kid of comfort. Look at all those things she got to play with. And even more than the toys are the people that came and helped her. Look at that. And we thank God for people that can come and help, and we thank God for each one of you. Each one of you are special. Each one of you have feelings, and we're going to give you out a little something for you to do over the summer vacation. It talks about Maria's kid of comfort, and then there's a really important page that you're going to say all about me, what you love, what your favorite holiday is, where you want to go, draw pictures. You are special. Okay, does anyone want to say a little prayer about the children? Anyone want to say a prayer for me? Just to pray for the children? You think I want to say a prayer? Oh, thank you so much for that positive endorsement. All right, everyone, bow your heads. God, thank you so much for being with us today. Thank you for these wonderful children. Children sometimes go through a difficult time too, Lord. But there are people here to help them. You send those people, Lord. And you love your children. Amen. Amen. God bless them. Amen. All right, friends. And then it's time to go to your room. Okay? Okay.
On the fifth.
Look at the bottom.
On fifth Sundays, usually our church has two different children's church classes. Guys, can you hold up for a second before going? Just wait.
Listen to Miss Renee.
But on fifth Sundays, we're going to combine the classes, and I'm going to be the teacher today. We're going to be in the younger classroom. So that's where we'll be. Like to come back and see the classroom, you're welcome.
Kids have so much energy. Praise the Lord for our children. Just need to see how quickly they're growing and to see their gifts maturing day by day. As I mentioned earlier in our service, the remainder of our time together is going to be quite a bit different than what we typically do here at First Church. So if this is your first time with us, we're usually a little more rambunctious than we're going to be today. Today's worship, the remainder, will be a form of Taizé worship, which usually It's accompanied by some candle lighting and things like that, which we're not going to do all of that at this point. But what I'd like to do is to lead us through a time of scripture, short choruses, personal and communal prayer. During our times of silence, which you can see them listed in the bulletin, will be on the screen too. I want to invite you to just be with the Lord, listen for God's voice. If you feel led to say something, that's wonderful too. You don't need to. We can sit in complete silence. Kind of drawing some on some of our Quaker roots as Church of the Brethren this morning. And you can see that there are several sections to our time of contemplation. The first, I think, should be fairly simple for any of us, and that is to contemplate God's goodness. I think just about any of us can think of ways that God has been good to us. So I thought we would start by reading a scripture responsively. Tyke, if you could do the slide for me. Somebody. Thank you. On the slides, the bold will be you all, and the part that's not bold will be the leader. So let's read Psalm 136, selected verses. Give thanks to the Lord, for he is good. Give thanks to the God of gods. Give thanks to the Lord of lords. To him who alone does great wonders. Who by his understanding made the heavens. Who spread out the earth upon the waters. Who made the great lights. The sun to govern the day. The moon and stars to govern the night. He remembered us in our low estate. And freed us from our enemies. He gives food to every creature. Give thanks to the God of heaven. Let's sing together.
Thank you.
God is good. All the time. Amen. Let's see. The next section after our personal time of lament will be a time to reflect on all that's going on in the world around us. So for this particular piece, I'd like us to focus more on our own shortcomings, on our own challenges, our own obstacles that we each must overcome, some obstacles that we place in our own way when striving to pursue our Lord. The grounding scripture can be seen there, and once again, I'll read the text that's not bold, and you'll be the text that is bolded. From Psalm 13. How long, Lord, will you forget me forever? How long will you hide your face from me?
How long must I wrestle with my thoughts, day after day, of sorrow in my heart?
How long will my enemy triumph over me? Look on me and answer, Lord, my God.
Give me light to my eyes, for I will speak to heaven, and my enemy will say,
but I trust in your unfailing love. My heart rejoices in your salvation.
I will sing the Lord's praise, for your name has been good to me.
Let's sing together. Spirit of God, descend on this place. Fill us to overflowing, Lord, as we cry out to you, Lord, in dealing with all that this recent season has brought about in our lives, Lord. The trauma of just not even being able to be together safely, those who we've lost in this season. We lament, Lord, our own shortcomings, Father, those times when we put things ahead of you, we put our own obstacles in the way. We cry out to you for forgiveness and for deliverance if we remain burdened, if we remain in chains, Lord. We just cry out for freedom today. We thank you that you are the deliverer, the healer of our every ill. Thank you for hearing our lament today, Lord. It's felt like almost every day something else awful has happened. Just one more gut punch. And it's, I'll be honest, it's hard to know what to do with that. It struck me this week as I was doing the prayer list for the bulletin. We had named a couple communities that had been affected by gun violence, and I had to take the names out because there's too many to list. War ravages throughout the world. Greed, death-dealing policies oppress people right here in this country as well as throughout the world. Prophet Isaiah has a word for a world in turmoil, and a word for us as well. So as we enter into this time of lament for the state of our world, let us look to the words of the prophet Isaiah, which are before you. Shout it aloud. Do not hold back. Raise your voice like a trumpet.
Declare to my people their rebellion and to the descendants of Jacob their persecutions.
For day after day they seek me out. They seem eager to know my ways, as if they were a nation that does what is right and has not forsaken the commands of its God. Why have we fasted, they say, and you have not seen it? Yet on the day of your fasting, you do as you please and exploit all your workers. You cannot fast as you do today and expect your voice to be heard on high. Is it only for bowing one's head like a reed, or for lying in sackcloth and ashes?
Fast,
Is not this the kind of fasting I have chosen? To loose the chains of injustice and untie the cords of the yoke, to set the oppressed free and to break every yoke.
Is it not enough to share?
Then your light will break forth like the dawn. Your healing will quickly appear. Then your righteousness will go before you, and the glory of the Lord will be your rear guard.
Then you will call, and the Lord will answer. You will cry for help, and he will say, "Hear me."
If you do away with the yoke of oppression, with the pointing finger and malicious talk,
and if you spare yourself and have hunger, and satisfy the needs of the oppressed, then you will make your prize as your house, and your rank will come from your name.
The Lord will guide you always, will satisfy your needs in a sun-scorched land, and will strengthen your frame.
You will be like a wild water garden, like a stream whose water is.
Your people will rebuild the ancient ruins and will raise up the age-old foundations.
You will recall and repair broken walls, restore the streets of other buildings.
Our world needs us to hear that word, to take it seriously, to be God's people. Can't help but see all over the place people who claim the name of the Lord and yet abide by oppression and abide by holding others down, and that's not what our God has called us to. Let's sing. part of breaking every yoke of oppression, your word says. Do what you want to do in and among us. So this is your ideology, so you can stay over there. I'm going to be over here with my people. It's the opposite of what we were created to be in the first place. So this next piece is a prayer for unity, and we'll rehearse the words of Jesus himself as he prayed for us before we ever existed. My prayer is not for them, meaning not all of us, alone, my prayer is not for them, meaning just my disciples, is what Jesus was saying, alone. I pray also for those who will believe in me through their message. May they also be in us, so that the world may believe that you have sent me.
I have given them the glory which you gave me, that they may be one as we are one.
That's tough to see. I in them, and you in me, so that they may be brought to complete unity. Then the world will know that you sent me and have loved them even as you have loved me.
Father, I want those who have given you.
And all together, righteous Father, though the world does not know you, I know you, and they think you have sent me. Let's sing together.
Thank you.
us to be in right relationship with you and in right relationship with each other. God, we pray that you'll bind your body together, that all of our gifts might work together to accomplish what you want us to accomplish, Father. Break down any barrier between us, Lord. Continue to weave us together as a family of faith. Outside of these walls, Lord, break down barriers. Help your creation to see one another as siblings in Christ, created in your image, just to see the beauty in each other, take away that which would keep us apart. Exceedingly and abundantly more than we could ever ask or think. And we just want to claim the fact that God will, God can make a way where we don't see one. God's about moving mountains. God's about creating a path, as we'll read together. God's about bringing water to a sun-scorched land. Let us read together parts of Psalm 107, and again, you guys will be the bold. Give thanks to the Lord, for he is good. His love endures forever. Let the redeemed of the Lord tell their story. Another version says, let the redeemed of the Lord say so. Those he redeemed from the hand of the foe.
Those he gathered from the lands, from east and west, from north and south. Some wandered in the desert wastelands, finding no way to a city where they could settle.
They were hungry and thirsty, and their lives ebbed away. Then they cried out to the Lord in their trouble, and he delivered them from their distress. He led them by a straight way to a city where they could settle.
Let them give thanks to the Lord for his unfailing love and his wonderful deeds for mankind. For he satisfies the thirsty and he fills the hungry with good things.
Some sat in darkness and in utter darkness, prisoners suffering in iron chains because they rebelled against God's command and despised the plans of the Most High.
So he subjected them to bitter labor. They stumbled, and there was no one to help. And they cried to the Lord in their trouble, and he saved them from their distress. He brought them out of the darkness, the utter darkness, and
Let them give thanks to the Lord for his unfailing love and his wonderful deeds for humankind. For he breaks down gates of bronze and cuts through bars of iron.
Some became fools through their rebellious ways and suffered affliction because of their iniquities. They loathed all food and drew their men against the dead. Then they cried to the Lord in trouble, and he saved them from their distress.
He sent out his word and healed them. He rescued them from the grave.
Let them give thanks to the Lord for his unfailing love and his wonderful deeds for mankind. Let them sacrifice and offerings and tell of his works songs of joy.
He turned the desert into pools of water and the parched ground into flowing springs. There he brought the hungry to live, and they founded a city where they could settle.
They sold fields and planted vineyards that yielded their fruitful harvest. He blessed them, and their numbers greatly increased, and he did not let their herds diminish.
And their numbers decreased, and they were humbled by oppression, calamity, and sorrow. He who pours contempt on nobles made them wander in a trackless waste. But he lifted the needy out of their affliction and increased their families like flocks.
The upright see and rejoice, but all the wicked shut their mouths. Let the one who lies keep these things and ponder the loving deeds of the Lord.
God can make a way where there is no way, church, and has made a way for each one of us. And for us as a faith community, God will continue to be at work in the world around us. And we want to acknowledge our God's goodness. We want to acknowledge that Jesus has risen, has conquered the grave, and that God will use us to be a part of the work that he is about doing right here and right now. Let's sing together.
Yeah.
is Lord. He is Lord. He is Lord. Thank you. Being victorious over anything the world can throw at us, Lord. We pray that your peace will overcome all the discord throughout the world today. Lord, we know that shalom and peace is more than just the absence of war. What we yearn for is a wholeness for all of humankind, Lord. What Dr. King called beloved community, that all of us might enjoy all that life together has to offer. God, help us to be a part of bringing that to reality. Lord, go with us from this place. Keep us safe until we can be together once again. Lord, we pray a blessing upon the food that we're going to partake in a moment. We thank you for the opportunity to hang out and to eat together. Thank you for those who've been working hard even while we're worshiping today to prepare some food today as well. God, we just pray that you'll go with us from this place, that as we leave, we'll be changed. Draw us ever closer to you and ever closer to one another. Lord, we praise you and thank you for being a good God, for who you are. In Jesus' name, amen. Amen. Hallelujah. God can go in peace and also head upstairs if you want to eat something. And we'll see you upstairs in a little bit.